I'm Chris Menard. Let's take a look at artificial intelligence inside of Microsoft 365. When I say artificial intelligence or AI, I am basically saying my computer can do tasks or give me results that an intelligent person would do. So I have two Excel examples. I'm going to pop into PowerPoint for two examples, but then I'll just list other AI integration because I'm trying to keep this video short. So this first one is a great example. I have in Excel this list of data. And if you notice, I have car brands in column B. I want to know what are the top three car brands. So without AI, here is what I would do. I would make obviously a pivot chart, insert. So I'm going to fly through this. I'm not sitting here explaining what I'm doing. But pivot chart, I want to know brand, I want to know invoice amount. I'll zoom in. The numbers are going to drive me crazy, so let me format them real quick. There's all my car brands. I just want to know the top three, so I come in here and hit value filters and make it the top three, and I hit OK. I don't need to sort them, but I am, just to make this easier to see. Mazda, Ford, Nissan, those are the top three car brands. Now, here is AI at work. I've got this data. I'm going to go to analyze data. I've already made a video on analyze data. So I'm just going to type in there they are, Mazda, Ford, Nissan. Just a quick check of the numbers, 3455.99. 3455.99, 3398, 3398, 3368925. There is a perfect match. I would hit insert pivot table and I am done. Wasn't that easy? And it even gave me this nice little title up here at the top. There's example number one. Example number two, I have this blank worksheet running. I'm going to throw in an image. I could do insert picture. There's the image. This is a screenshot of some Microsoft financial data, but I don't want to have to retype all of this on my screen. So artificial intelligence example number two, when I go to the data tab from picture, I can either pull from an image I've saved, but I could also just pull this from my clipboard, which I have it on. It's going to open up a task pane on the right hand side. It's going to analyze the data. I'm just going to hit insert data, insert anyway. Zoom in, move this around so we can check it real quick. There is example number two. Everything in column A is correct. Taking a look at column B and C, those numbers look correct to me. Really cool here. And what's also cool is these numbers actually came in as numbers, which they should be. And this other information came in as text. Also, the percentages are correct. That was example number two from Excel for AI. Let's pop over into PowerPoint right now. I have PowerPoint running. So this is going to be example number three. I need to do this presentation about the city of Atlanta. And I have noticed that I'm saying a lot or so. I'm using a lot of filler words. I've also been accused of talking too fast. So I'm going to go to slideshow and use the rehearse coach. This is AI in PowerPoint. It's going to start my PowerPoint presentation and I'm going to intentionally throw some out there. I'm not going to run all the way through this. Again, I'm trying to keep this video short, but you'll see a summary slide at the end. So let's jump in right now with this. Start rehearsing. Show real-time feedback. I do have that checked. Hello, this is Chris Menard. I appreciate you joining me for this session right now. So I stopped it. I didn't want to run all the way through that, but I've got a video on this also, but it's going to come back and tell you right here about your filler words. It's going to tell you if you're speaking too quickly right here. Really cool feature, and you can rehearse again. Example number four of AI. Again, I need to quickly make a presentation. I'm using this for one of my kids' schools. Projects, history of the Roman Empire. So we'll go to file, new. Let me use the QuickStarter. It gives you suggestions down here already. I'm gonna just type in Roman Empire. I've got quite a few in here. I'm gonna just pick this one that says history. You decide what slides you want. When you hit next, it's probably gonna ask you what layout you want or what theme. There you go. I'm gonna take this one and hit create. So I used AI to quickly get me started with the presentation. This is intentional. Some of your slides are gonna be hidden because it's letting you know what to do when you actually run your slideshow. There is my agenda also right there. Really cool feature. Other examples of artificial intelligence in Microsoft Word. Word will now start completing some of your sentences for you. That is AI. Resume Assistant in Microsoft Word. It ties into LinkedIn. If you're looking for a job, it'll give you some great bullet points about certain job descriptions. In Microsoft Teams, one of my favorite features is when I'm in a meeting, I can turn on the live captions. I may want to see live captions in English. The live captions are immediate, but somebody else that's in that meeting may want to see the live captions in Spanish or in another language. Microsoft has you covered there with Microsoft Teams live captions. You actually also have live captions in PowerPoint now that I'm thinking about it. Over in Outlook, which I'm in every day, I need to schedule a meeting, whether it's internally or internally and externally. We have the Microsoft app called FindTime, which works inside of Outlook. People have a voting poll and they have three options: no, I can't attend, yes, or preferred. It takes those times, and if you tell it to, it automatically will schedule a Microsoft Teams meeting for you. That is AI at work in Outlook. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for your time. Feel free to subscribe to my channel.